I am a girl with Asperger's syndrome. I'm the Aspie girl.
Hi guys, it's Alexa. Welcome to my channel. As you may or may not know, I filmed a high school freshman survival guide around a year ago. You can go watch that video if you'd like. Well, this video is going to be a survival guide for those of you entering middle school. If you're transitioning from elementary school to middle school, I hope this video helps you. I know the new school year has already started for most of you, but I'm making this video anyway. Let's get into it. First off, I need to let you know that middle school is very different from elementary school. The transition from elementary school to middle school is going to be a very drastic change. You may be lost and confused for the first couple weeks, but you'll get used to it eventually. The first difference is that instead of being with the same class and having the same teacher all day, you'll go to different classes throughout the day and have a different teacher for each class. This is what they call periods. Also, instead of following your class everywhere all day, you'll be given a schedule to follow. Your schedule will tell you which classes you'll have during what periods, where all of your classes are, which teachers you'll have for each class, and which days, marking periods, and semesters you'll have your classes. Now, do not lose or misplace your schedule. It's important to hold on to your schedule at all times, especially during the beginning of the school year and everyone is learning where their classes are. If you're confused about your schedule or you're lost trying to find your classes, don't be afraid to ask a teacher for help. Also, you can get a map of the school and follow it. Don't worry about your teachers getting upset with you or marking you as late if you happen to get lost during the first couple weeks of school. Your teachers will understand that you're new to the school and you don't know your way around yet. You could also ask an older student for help, but teachers are way more trustworthy. However, don't use the fact that you're a new student as an excuse to cut class. If you cut class, the hidden cameras in the hallways will catch you and you will get in trouble. The next difference between elementary and middle school is that instead of having a cubby, you'll have a locker. And unlike a cubby, you have to put in a combination to get into your locker. If you have trouble remembering your locker combination, just write it down somewhere safe where you can look at it anytime. If you're just transitioning from elementary school to middle school, this may disappoint you, but you're no longer going to have recess. This may upset you at first, but you'll get used to it eventually. Recess is actually meant for little kids to get their energy out. Once you're in middle school, you'll no longer even need recess because you're already past the age of playing. You'll still have lunch though, don't worry about that. Another difference is that you'll no longer have snack time, but you can still bring a snack to school if you'd like. And you can have a snack in class as long as it's okay with the teacher. Now that you know what to expect when entering middle school, I'm now going to give you a few tips on how to ease your way into the new school year and succeed in middle school. First off, get everything you need a few weeks in advance. Get your schedule, a map of the school, a backpack, your school supplies, and if you're going to a private school, your school uniform. Make sure to get a backpack and school supplies that'll fit inside of your locker. Also, don't believe those rumors that your older siblings or people like that tell you about middle school. They are not true, so don't take them seriously. For example, my older sister warned me about how mean one of the computer teachers at my middle school was. But that computer teacher ended up being not only really nice, but my favorite teacher of all time. I actually made a video a month and a half ago telling the story about how that teacher impacted me. So feel free to go check that video out. also, just because it's middle school doesn't mean that the kids are going to be mean. When I was in middle school, the kids were actually really nice, and I was still able to make friends. Also, your friends from elementary school will most likely be going to the same middle school as you, so you can still be friends with them. If you have older siblings, you can also ask them for advice about middle school. Also, your middle school will most likely have a tour for the new students that you can go to. Once you have gotten used to being in middle school, try to get good grades. Pay attention in class, do your homework and hand it in on time. Don't be absent too much. Don't cheat when taking a quiz or test. Study when you have a quiz or test coming up, and just do your work in general. If you need help, don't be afraid to ask for it. Some teachers are helpful, others are not. If you need help but your teacher won't help you, try getting a tutor. Tutors are there to help you if you need it. Also, don't strive to be cool or popular or anything like that. All you need is one or two good friends. That's all. The truth is, once you reach high school, your social status in middle school won't matter. Lastly, try to stay out of trouble. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed watching my middle school survival guide, and I hope you have a great middle school experience. If you like this video, please subscribe for more videos on my channel. I post a new video every Friday. If you have any questions or requests for upcoming videos, please comment them down below. Thank you for watching. Bye!